Today we're going to be using a CXT20S for small gland for our SY flex. The gland plaque comprises of four brass rings, two brass lock nuts, two gland bodies with gland nuts, two shrouds and two earthing rings.
Okay then, we're going to make off SY flex. First of all, we're going to need to put the shroud on the same way as we did with our steel wire armoured one. Making sure that the shroud is nice and tight and doesn't slip down the SY cable when it's in position. Got a nice tight fix. Okay, next I'm going to put on is, and it's usually forgotten, next I'm going on the gland body with the gland nut already attached. And my first brass washer goes on next. Okay, and now we're ready to facilitate the termination of the cable. Depending on what it's going into, in this case we're going into a consumer unit, we're going to need it to be at least as long again. So at least as long again from the consumer unit for us at college. Next, once we've got our length, take our knife. Can be reasonably firm with a knife because obviously the braided underneath shouldn't be cut through with a knife, but still a little bit more care than when we were taking our knife to our steel wire armoured cable. It's not quite as firm as that. So score around with our knife. Okay, and open it out. And then hopefully it will pull away. Gently twist as we go, so it's like you're wringing it out. So just gently pull away as we go away. Off to the outside, here we go. It's moving a bit quicker now. There we go. Okay, so we're in that position there. What we're going to do next is remove some of the braiding. We don't need it all. We need about 4 centimetres or 40 millimetres at the bottom maximum. To do that, I think it's easier just to bulge it down. Bring it down into a bulge position at about 3 to 4 centimetres. Take our side cutters and we're just going to trim off the excess that we don't need all the way around. Okay, take off the excess. We're left with about 3 to 4 centimetres of braided at the end and we're just going to open that out. We can either use scriber, in our case a braddle, or our terminal screwdriver within our toolboxes. So I'm going to split it 50-50, one side and then 50% on the other side. Sorry, 50-50 split. Take my, in this case, braddle down, separating out the strands on one side. So I separated it that side, go around to the other side, 50% of the way around the cable, and separate the other side. So approximately half the braiding either side then. And we've got a nice 50-50 split. Straighten it out. Some people say at this stage that you can twist them. Depends on the glands you've got and the size of the slots within it. We could probably get away with actually twisting at this stage, but we're not going to. Just going to get them flat to start with. Okay, once they're flat, turn them 90 degrees and flatten them out again. Turn it 90 degrees and flatten it out again. Bring up the gland. Must make sure that we've got one of the washers in place, two slots lined up with the 50% split in the braid, and down we go into position, and then we're going to twist them this time, and twist them up nice and tight. It's important that we get them nice and tightly twisted, so don't give up, just keep going from the bottom, working my way out and as tight as I possibly can on both sides. Now what we're going to do is we're going to have them so they follow the way round, and the actual locking nut's going to come on and go this way round. So to make sure it stays tight, we're going to actually wrap it around that way, so when it turns and tightens on, it actually pulls the braiding round the way that you're actually tightening down. So we're going to push it round, just short of where it meets the back of the one that's already there. Trim it back, retwist it, take some time to set it into position as best you can, because it will cause you less problems later on. So we're in that position just short of it there. This one's going to come around this way. Position it round just short of where it meets the previous one. Into position. Like so, maybe just trim a little bit more off. Okay. We're in that position there. We can now offer on the second washer. And what will happen is when we tighten this into our position, it will actually clamp, the two washers will clamp against the braiding and make continuity to the braiding itself, so it will give it an earth. From this position, I've already prepared the consumer unit itself. I know lots of people don't like it, but we actually want the best possible electrical connection, so the paint's been removed. I've highlighted it with a red pen, so you can see the paint has been taken away. That facilitates the earthing ring to be positioned on the outside, okay, like so. If you want to, at this stage, you can remove the outside PVC to expose the conductors, about 15-20 mil up, so we don't rub against the body, exactly the same as we did with the steel or armoured gland. Gently score round as we did before. This can be done when it's in position, but you might find it easier to do it at this stage. Similar to the technique we use for opening up flex, we fold it over and wait for it to burst. Once we've got it going, hopefully it will work its way around. Again, you might need to rock the knife in as we did when we did flexes early on in the course. We want to expose our conductors. There we go. See them start coming through now. One more little bit there, just gently with a knife. Roll it across. You can expose our conductors. As you can see, our three-core SY Flex has a green and yellow circuit protective conductor and two black conductors, which are numbered 1 and 2, and we can identify them as line and neutral at the ends, making sure the corresponding numbers are at the other terminate at the end, and we will prove that during the testing process. And finally, the gland's got to be fitted to our enclosure. Our enclosure will be screwed to the wall. This one's here for demonstration purposes only, using the same 20mm lock nut spanner we used with the steel wire armoured on the inside. I've now put in my roofing nut and bolt to hold my earthing ring in place during the tightening up process, and the adjustable spanner on the outside to hold the body. We would then tighten up the lock nut from inside, holding the body still on the outside, locking the nut off, ensuring also that the braided stays within the body as we go. So it's a case of making sure, maybe with the back of a knife, that we press it into position and have it held in all the way around. So must check the back when we're tightening it up. It's easier when it's on the wall to see that and just keep poking it back in, either with the back of the knife or a screwdriver, to make sure we clamp between the two washers the braided work in order that it gets the best possible electrical connection to earth. Once we've made sure our gland is now tight into our enclosure, the two brass washers are crushing the braided part between them, making the best possible electrical connection. We can nip up this part of the gland to prevent the ingress of moisture. So we just need to take our adjustable grips and just nip that up. Okay, so it's nice and firm, okay? Okay, I can't turn it with my fingers, it's nice and firm. It doesn't need to be super tight, it'll actually end up spurging out the seal within there and not being a moisture barrier then. The gland is now finished, the shroud can be pushed into position, and the internal fly lead for connection to the circuit protective conductor can be added.